back in week 10. Week 9 was an incredible week for me. Went 5-0 across all of my picks. Told you to take the Chiefs, Bengals, Seahawks, the Saints, and Pittsburgh, who killed the Baltimore Ravens on Sunday Night Football. That is just an incredible week for me. The best week so far out of all my videos this season. And can I just take a little bit of time to acknowledge the Miami Dolphins for beating the Chargers 37-0, making the Chargers lay a goose egg in Miami. That is an incredible feat because everybody has San Diego in the playoffs. That's not to say they're not in the playoffs, but nobody definitely saw that game coming. Time to get into the week 10 games. My first lock of the week, I'm telling you to take Cincinnati over Cleveland. Cincinnati favored by 6 at home. This game is just looking like a great matchup because the AFC North is definitely one of the strongest divisions in the NFL this season. Both teams coming off great wins from week 9. So definitely look for Cincinnati to kind of show up in prime time. They haven't really put away teams because their defense is ranked 30th. Can you believe that? The Cincinnati Bengals defense. 30th in the league, where last year they were one of the top 5 defenses in the league. They have to learn to close out games, and I think starting with the Browns on Thursday Night Football will do that for them. For my second lock of the week, I'm telling you to take the injured Dallas Cowboys at the Jacksonville Jaguars. It seems to be a trend here picking whoever plays against the Jaguars because they are practically last in everything in the division, besides the Raiders, who still have not won a game. The Dallas Cowboys are coming off a crucial loss to the Cardinals. And then, by the way, the Cardinals have proven themselves that, hey, we are a team. We are the best team in the NFL. This is a game that Dallas needs to win. Tony Romo hurt. Now it's Brandon Weeden in there, who didn't look that well in last week's game when he came in. But Jacksonville, don't forget, put up 23 points against Cincinnati's D. But just keep feeding DeMarco Murray the ball, and the Dallas Cowboys will win in Jacksonville on Sunday. The last lock of the week, I'm telling you to take the Baltimore Ravens hosting the Tennessee Titans. The Titans coming off a bye week, which means they're going to be ready to play against the Ravens, whereas the Ravens are favored by 10 and lost to Pittsburgh in Pittsburgh, one of the biggest rivalries in football, by 20 points. That is a lot for a rivalry. If you think about it, most of their games in the past, I don't even know, 5-6 years have been within 3 points, maybe 7 points, not even 20 points. That is just an incredible way to win a game against a division rival, especially when it's the Steelers-Ravens. Look for the Ravens at home to just demolish the Titans, take all their energy out on them, and get back into the playoff race for the AFC North. For my upset pick this week, gotta give a little bit of an edge to the Miami Dolphins. Not favored, traveling to Detroit. Detroit's coming off a bye week after beating the Falcons in London on a botched kick that didn't go in, and then it went in and nobody knew what happened, and the Lions won by 1, but doesn't matter. The Lions came back, but Miami shut out the Chargers last week 37-0. That was just an incredible win on their part, and look for them to make a splash in Detroit, with Detroit favored by 2.5. So my upset pick this week is going to the Dolphins. This week's game of the week, 2-4-4 teams going at it. The San Francisco 49ers traveling to the New Orleans Saints. The Saints looking like the dominant team in the NFC South, whereas the 49ers had an embarrassing 1-yard loss to the St. Louis Rams. Kaepernick should be ashamed of himself. The Rams D deserves all the credit in that game for beating the Seahawks and then turning around and then beating the freaking 49ers. So the 49ers are on the road this week. Look for them to be disheveled when they travel to New Orleans, and Drew Brees takes apart their defense. Both of these teams are highly ranked. The Saints second overall in offensive yards per game. This 49ers second ranked defense in yards per game. This is going to be a great, great matchup, but I don't see the Saints losing in New Orleans. Tensa switching it up this week, taking his own team, the Pittsburgh Steelers, to beat the Jets. He's taking the Denver Broncos to go into Oakland and take care of the Raiders. And he's taking Arizona in an NFC West showdown. His upset pick of the week, though, my team, the Atlanta Falcons, traveling to Tampa Bay. This game is favored at 0, so it is a very good upset pick because it's a flip of a coin. So if he gets it right, he gets it. If he loses, he doesn't. But the Falcons look like the stronger team in that matchup, so that looks like a great pick. And for the game of the week, he's taking the New Orleans Saints. This week's viewers pick segment goes out to Doug Barrett 619 part 2. I'm gonna put up his 3 locks of the week, his upset pick, and then his Game of the Week pick. Be sure to comment below, and I will try to get everybody in here that views these to get their locks of the week in, to get their picks in. If you're commenting, if you're liking the video, I'm going to be more likely to pick you if you're interacting with me on my videos. So definitely get in there. It'll get you some airtime and let people know who you're taking that week. Hope you guys enjoyed the week. Here's the comment section of the week. Big shout out to ShadowFox4562 for taking the Dolphins over the Chargers, whereas I cannot say enough how big of a game that was for the Dolphins, how much swagger they're going to get from that. Be sure to tune in to next week for week 11. Comment down below who you think is definitely your lock of the week. If you had to pick one team, if you were in a survivor pool this week, doesn't matter what team you pick, which one are you taking for the win? Best comments will make it in the comment section of the week for week 11, so be sure to check that out. Get back to me, like this, subscribe. I'll see you guys next week.